Good morning everyone, it is Sunday today and Kenny and I are about to pop into town and get some brunch and then I think we're going to go to the dog shop. Excuse me! Good morning, Rue. And then I think we're going to go to the dog shop that I showed you last week because they ordered that pink jumper in for Rue. And then I might quickly pop into Selfridges and grab a couple of hair bits, actually. I shared on my Instagram stories that because I keep curling my hair, I feel like I'm starting to notice a little bit of dryness and I've never noticed anything like that with my hair before, so I'm panicking a bit and I think I might run into Selfridges and pick up like some hair masks, some heat protecting spray and just all the stuff that might help. And then obviously we will have Rue's walk later and Kenny and I want to do a big organise the house. I feel like I say this in every video and that is because I don't know how people who are busy stay on top of their house. Like I've absolutely not mastered that yet. I make the house like perfect, everything's organised and in its right place, and then honestly 2 weeks later it's as if I never did anything. So we're still working on that. I need to find a method that works for us to keep this house in order. I am bringing you into this. I can see your Milo on here and your wash bag once again. Anyway, for now it's weekly resets and then just desperately try and keep on top of it throughout the week. But yeah, I thought we would just weekly vlog again this week and see where the week takes us. So let's go get some breakfast. We've just been in to pick up Rue's jumper. She looks so cute, I can't cope. I've never felt cold like this. It's like biting at my nose and my hands and everything. But we're nearly at brunch. Just waiting for a table.
Show everyone your new coat.
Thank you, so good. Aww. Isn't she doing the nicest sits with mom and dad? Just saying to Kenny, they do a kim cheese toasty. I can't have it because it's with real cheese, but how yum. That's what I make the vegan version of sometimes. I am gonna have this vegan breakfast. I've had it once before and it's really good. And then, of course, probably a tamarind latte. So, just finished breakfast. Kenny has gone home with Rue. I think he might actually take her out for a walk. And I'm just on my way to Selfridges to see if they've got any of the hair bits that I'm after in stock. Girls, do you know what? I love this bodysuit, but let me just say, it is not the one for walking long distances in. Uncomfortable, just very, very uncomfortable. So I'm desperate to take this off. But just got back and I did pick up the two. I'm talking really weird because my face is so cold. But I managed to get the two bits that I went for. So first and foremost, I got the Jisoo, that's how you pronounce it, heat protecting spray. Sorry, I've said that wrong. And then just because I keep seeing everyone talk about it and everyone needs a great dry shampoo in their cupboard, I thought I would try this Living Proof dry shampoo. I'm pretty sure when I used to work at Space NK when I was like 16, when I went in on like a Sunday or something and my hair wasn't freshly washed, I'm pretty sure I used to use this. I'm gonna get changed out of this bodysuit that is suffocating me. And then we're gonna have a really chilled afternoon. Kenny's taken Rue out already, so we don't need to do that. And I'm just gonna tidy, read, all the usual stuff. So let's go get changed. So we're going to have a roast for dinner. And Kenny bought this quiche today. I don't know if that's actually for dinner tonight or not, but the other day I bought one of these nut roasts. This is what I bought in my Waitrose order, actually, if you saw last week's video. So we're gonna have this and then obviously all the usual bits that go with the roast. We've got some potatoes, more potatoes. We've got pepper, carrots, celery. I quite like roasted celery. Don't know if that's rogue, but I do quite like that. And then Kenny just got back from the shop, so we've got some other bits in here, some beetroot, I'm sure we'll have that. What are these? Are these kombuchas? Yeah, he's bought us two ginger kombuchas. I think what's in here? Oh, more potatoes. and I have once again been confined to the bedroom. Apparently it's football Sundays. I'm sure some of you can relate. So I thought I might start my new book. I finished The Miracle Morning. I don't know if I'd already finished that in the last video, but I finished The Miracle Morning. Loved it. I am still doing my little book review thing every week on Instagram. So I wrote a bit of a review on that. And then the next one on the non-fiction list is Breaking the Habit of Being Yourself by Joe Dispenza. How to Lose Your Mind and Create a New One. And I'm guessing this is all about rewiring the parts of us that we want to rewire. One of the things I actually talked to Kenny about yesterday is something I have always told myself. I forgot I was going to start this today, but you know, there's always tomorrow. Something I've always told myself is that I can't run. I've always said, like, I'm not a runner, I can't run. And I was saying to Kenny that I think it comes from doing cross country at school. If you're not from the UK, is cross country a thing in every single country? It's basically just like a run outside that we had to at school in our PE lessons. Oh, hey. And anyway, I was really bad at that. So I feel like ever since then, bearing in mind I was probably like 13 at the time, I've just said I can't run. So this is a long story, but to say that one of the things I've thought about trying this year, more from the point of view of just like challenging one of the little like limiting beliefs that I have about myself, because I'd honestly say that's a very ingrained one. Like, it's part of my identity if someone's like, oh, I'm going for a run. And I don't know, like, he actually spoke about this in The Miracle Morning, and the way he described looking at other runners is just like these different creatures. Like, when I see people going for a run, it's just not relatable to me. Anyway, I'll let you know if I do start running and how that goes. That's just something I've been thinking about. And I guess this book is probably going to be along similar lines. So I'll let you know how I get on with this one. That's what we're going to do now, hey? Until our roast is ready. Look how good these potatoes look. Kenny said that I can try one, but that's only because he's eaten this half. But thanks for saving a half for me. So yum. Excuse all the trays on the table in the background, but we're just helping ourselves. So this is our roast now. It's all done. We've got some chard. We've got roasted red pepper, roasted carrots, celery. This is beetroot here, roast potatoes, roast garlic. And then this is a quiche and this is a nut roast. And then in this little jug, which I'm about to do, we've got our gravy. And then I'm just having a kombucha as well. I am just about to take off my makeup. And I thought I would give you a really quick skincare update, because I don't remember the last time I did this. And I feel like things could have potentially changed. I thought I'd quickly just run you through it anyway, just in case. I'm not sure why I'm out of breath putting my hair up. But okay, first things first, I take my makeup off, and I have done forever using the Inculus Hyaluronic Acid Cleanser. I find that this gets all my makeup off. If I'm wearing powder and a heavier makeup, I normally do like a double cleanse with that just to make sure everything's off. And then I always get a wet flannel and like really give my face a good scrub. You'd be amazed at how much makeup is still left on even after double cleansing. So give that a good wipe. And then most days, this is like my everyday routine, I now use this, which I showed you in the last video. Absolutely love this, like love, love, love. It's such like a light, nice formula, and it smells so fresh, it's so nice. And I think I need to like properly look this up because I'm not a skincare guru, but I'm pretty sure this replaces my hyaluronic acid because it said something about hyaluronic acid. I'm not sure. If I'm not using that though, I use without fail every single time, morning and night, the Inculus Hyaluronic Acid. This has like been my skincare routine for months and months. This one is just a new addition. But if I can use them together, I'm gonna Google this, if I can use them together, then I will do that. And then I use polyglutamic acid, which again is just like a hydrating thing, so that goes on. And then next I use this. As always, I always go on about this, but the light skin food. If your skin is okay with the regular skin food, go for it. It's just that for some reason the regular one breaks me out. I think it's too heavy. But again, I've used that for months. Interested, this is my, some of these might be a bit, you know, gross. But yeah, if you're interested, this is my face tan that I use. And then I've recently started using Revitalash eyelash serum again, because I used to religiously use this and it makes the biggest difference. It's very pricey, but genuinely nothing grows your eyelashes like this. And then recently I was sent very kindly the Rapid Lash and Rapid Brow. Obviously I've already got a lash serum open. I think these ones are a bit more affordable, so I thought I'd try the brow one on my brows just to see what it does. I'll let you know if I see any difference. And I think Oh, this, I've been meaning to tell you about this because this, I got this from TikTok, and this is the best stuff I've ever used at healing spots. So let me be super clear about this. If you have a spot, you know when you have a spot that's like turned into a bit of like a scar, like it's dried out, it's not really a spot anymore, but it's just hanging around because it's really dry and isn't healing really quickly. This is what this is amazing for. It's so, so good. I'll show you the actual packaging. I probably wouldn't use it on like a new spot because it's very moisturizing, and I feel like the general advice is like drying for new spots. I don't know. But as like a healing thing when you just want them to go because they've been there for like a week, this has honestly been like life-changing. Like it makes a difference overnight. The only other thing I've been using for the past couple of months is these Dr. Dennis peels. Again, these are very pricey, but I do not use this every single day, so it ekes it out, makes it a bit more affordable. I just use these maybe like max twice a week. I mostly use them when I've like worn loads of makeup for a few days in a row and I feel like I just want to strip my face of anything. I use those ones. And that is literally everything. I know I'm out of breath. It's because I crouch down because the light's in here. I always just put this backlight, but like if I stand up here, I'm in shade, so I always crouch down to talk to you. You know this whole running thing we were talking about earlier? Maybe that would be good for me. But yeah, I'm gonna get this all off now. Can you see what I mean? There's still, I don't know if it's on her, still so much makeup on her. I don't understand how. My little face towel bin is the best thing ever. Just do that, throw it in there, put them all in the wash once a week, and they don't go moldy. And it doesn't even smell damp as long as I do it religiously once a week. Good morning, everyone. I'm crouching down because I'm balancing on a water bottle currently in the kitchen. Excuse me. You can guess by Rue's complaints what's about to happen next. So it's been a few days because honestly, this week has just been non-stop, like back-to-back work stuff. And obviously for me, work is just a lot of like sitting at a computer that is probably not that interesting for you guys. I know, I'm dressed to go somewhere. It's actually Thursday today, and I last spoke to you on Sunday. That is how manic this week has been. It's flown by. But I've got the afternoon off today. So first job on the list is I'm gonna take Rue for a walk. Then we'll come back, we'll make some lunch. And then I don't really know what I'm doing with my afternoon because like I said, I've got a free afternoon. I need to do a tiny bit of editing, but that won't take too long. But honestly, I'm too old to stand in this position. My back feels like it's gonna, you know, give way. So let's head out on a walk. We are doing a city walk today, which I have to say is my least favourite kind of walk, really. But we have to do what we have to do because I think I've mentioned this before, but where we are living, there's a 6 month wait for a parking space. So obviously we've only got the one parking space, and that's the car that Kenny and I both drive, which is Kenny's car really. So I can only really use that when he doesn't need it. Come on, bug. But yeah, that's definitely one of the big things I'm looking forward to. When we do finally move, I can get my own car and have freedom every day. But there we go. Gotta make do with this for today. This is Rue's favourite person on the planet.
It is, isn't it?
We've only just got home. We've been honestly out for about 2 hours. I thought we'd be like an hour max, but I ended up having a really long phone call with my sister, and then Rue insisted on going to her favourite place in the entire world, as you probably saw, which is the flower shop Flourish in Manchester, if you're from Manchester. So then I picked up these tulips and lavender, which smells so nice. Anyway, I don't think I've ever felt hunger like this, and there is basically nothing in the fridge, so we're going to make something up today. What have we got? I think that's that. Mix in some of this, and what is this? Cheese. So we are working with empty cupboards, but what we're going to make is there's some couscous here from last night. Then these, I think, hopefully, yeah, this is like a bag of little kalettes, which are my fave. Kimchi, and then got some vegan cheese. And we're just gonna make like a one pot warm thing. Kimchi fried couscous kind of vibe. I'll show you guys how I make it. It's not going to be the most stunning meal you've ever seen, but this is the kind of thing I actually eat really quite often. It's like a super realistic, quick, throw whatever is in the fridge into a pan. Only one pan as well. Minimal washing up is always key. And just see what happens. I recently finished her whole lunch. I am starving, so let's get on with it. Kind of thing I'll always just throw together when I want something warm and comforting, but also like really, really quick. I did not have the patience today to cook like a soup or anything like fancy. My method is, if all else fails, take everything you've got in the fridge, throw it into a pan with olive oil, salt, pepper, garlic flakes, and I've added cheese today, and like it always turns out good. Is anyone watching anything good on like Netflix or Disney or Amazon or anything? Because even Apple TV, I have Apple TV. I've not watched any TV. I mean, not that that's a bad thing, but I haven't watched any TV at all for like a good couple of weeks because I can't find anything that I want to watch. And I really wanted to watch White Lotus, but we don't have whatever it's on. Is it on Now TV or something in the UK? We don't have that, so I can't watch that. Sorry, excuse me talking and eating. So if anyone's got any good recommendations of anything that I could watch, because what I love is I love a TV show to put on in the background, like, you know, when you're having your lunch or you're cooking or whatever. I really like something to watch in the background, and I finished Emily in Paris. Since then, I haven't found anything, so let me know. I've made an impulse decision that we're gonna bake some cookies because I really want to actually have this afternoon off. And I feel like a great way to do that is to do some baking, make some delicious chocolate cookies, and then I can sit, read a book, have a cup of tea, and a cookie. I've not baked for the longest time, but number one, we've got some chocolate in here. I actually got it from, what's it called, in America. So I'm in New York, and it's just been hanging around because I don't really love it. It's not my fave. Do we have any more? I've been really, really bad recently at like work-life balance. I think just because obviously my whole job is like based from my home, and you always feel like there's more you could do. And Kenny said to me the other day, he actually got a bit annoyed with me the other day and said like that I hadn't had a day off this year yet, which I guess on the 26th of January is probably not a great thing. So I'm really genuinely going to try and have the afternoon off. So we're going to bake some cookies. While they're in the oven, I'm going to clear up because I've been filming reels again this morning, and you know what that means for the room in there. And then once the cookies are done, that is my signal that we are done today. Sit down, big cup of tea, a book, probably a book. I'm reading Harry Potter and the Chamber of Secrets. We're still on the Harry Potter hype. And I've not had time to read, so we're going to make time for that this afternoon. But yeah, so let's make some cookies. These are, I'm going to use, drum roll please, yep, Deliciously Ella's app, and bake some cookies from there. I'm thinking these ones. These are not the ones I normally bake, but they look so good, don't they? Yep. Oh, yum, but we don't have any hazelnuts. Oh, the food on here just looks so good. Look at these ones. They look good as well, don't they? So let's check what ingredients I've actually got. I also need to weigh how much chocolate this is, because it's not really enough. 65 grams. How much do you need for that recipe? Oh, 60 grams. Okay, perfect. So we'll make this one then. So let me get all the other bits. I will show you. There's the recipe with all the measurements for you to screenshot. And then the method is really, really simple. So I'll just show you how I do it. Let's do this.
I was never the one to write up a song for just anyone. I was always the one to find myself lost in all conversations, oh. Cause I've always been told that things will unfold if you keep on waiting. But then you came along and proved me all wrong. I was so mistaken. Cause you glue all the pieces back together. Yeah, you take all my wrongs and make them better. Yeah, you're making me wanna try.
Excuse me, I don't think that's just a bed for Rue, is it? That's actually Mum's scarf, I think, Rue. I think you'll find. You can have it for now. Well, this is today's outcome from filming reels this morning. Even worse today because I did multiple outfits. So we better get going before the cookies burn.
I feel so free, oh my sweet baby. Never the one to give up the ghost. No, I was so stuck. I kept on playing my part, wanted to give up cause nothing was changing. But with you it's so clear, and now that you're here I see colors in every spectrum. Cause I finally learned my lesson. Cause you glue all the pieces back together.
This is my little setup for the afternoon at my desk. I've got one of the cookies. I haven't tried it yet, but they look good. And then I just bought my flowers in here to put by my desk as well.
I did exactly what I said I wasn't going to do, and I ended up working for the rest of the afternoon. So it's now 7:30, makeup has had to come off, and I'm in the kitchen and I'm cooking some dinner, just some super quick dinner tonight. So I'm gonna make brown rice pasta with my homemade pesto, which I definitely put the recipe in a recent video, so I'll link that down below. Pesto, I'm gonna put some artichokes in there, I'm gonna put some capers in there, and then we're gonna do a load of greens with garlic on the side, and that is gonna be dinner tonight, I think.
In here, we've got beetroot, kaelets, some garlic, and then we're having some courgette as well. Brown rice pasta all ready to go. Some chopped artichoke to go in. There's our courgettes, just need to warm them back up. And then we're gonna add in some tomatoes, some capers, and this is obviously my pot of homemade pesto that's gonna go in as well. Like a little boiled egg today. I say morning, it's only just about morning. I've had such a slow start to the day today. Something I've noticed about myself is that I'm such like an all or nothing person. I either like wake up at 7:30, do a workout, do my reading, do like a 12-hour day at work, not have any breaks, or I do nothing. Like if I wake up and I think I've got a day off, for some reason I just end up, I don't know what it is. I don't know if it's because I don't know what to do with myself. I don't know whether it's because I have this idea that I've got the whole day, so then I end up like just doing nothing. Oh, I don't know. Anyway, we're having a bit of one of those days today, so we're off to a bit of a slow start, but that's okay. As I always say to you, the best way to get out of like a bit of an unproductive slow start to the day is just to do something to break the sofa cycle. Just go out for a walk, go to the gym, tidy your house, just anything that gets you up off the sofa and doing something productive. So that's what I'm doing. I'm gonna go walk Rue and get this day going. But while I've got you, I wanted to run an idea past you. Now, Adele, if you're watching this, Adele is the lovely girl that does my nails. Adele, if you're watching this, I'm not making any promises. I know we talked about this, but there's something that I have been thinking about trying because I need to give it a go first to see if it's actually going to be realistic. But I was thinking of trialing Wednesday, Sunday videos with the idea that Wednesdays would be more focused on, well, I've thought of the name of like Wellness Wednesdays, that just came to my mind, but it's going to be more like my what I eat in a day, my reset days, when I do Q&As and stuff like that. All of that kind of stuff would be mostly on Wednesdays, and then every Sunday I would do a vlog, so whether that's like a weekly vlog or a day in the life or something like that, just like super realistic day in the lifestyle stuff, because vlogs are actually all I watch on YouTube. I don't watch anything other than people's vlogs, and I love watching vlogs, and I love making vlogs and just bringing you guys along with whatever I'm up to that week. I kind of feel like I connect with you a lot better in vlog because it's just like actually what is going on, and we can just talk about whatever rather than like a specific topic or theme to the video, if you know what I mean. But anyway, that's something I'm just thinking about, which is why we've had a little bit of like Wednesday, Sunday activity. But please let me know what you think, and if you guys like that idea, then I will do my absolute best to make that happen for us. look at this lovely present I've just come home to from Rue. Did someone find a stick and decide that this was the perfect place to chew it into pieces? So we'll have to get the Hoover on that. But I'm just making some lunch. This bread is so nice. It's potato bread. These are like little chunks of potato, but I think it's like rosemary as well. Then I got some homemade soup Kenny very kindly made me yesterday. Gonna toast up some of this bread and have some lunch. I know that loads and loads of people have already talked about this Davina McCall podcast, but I just wanted to say that I am not like a huge Davina McCall fan. I've never really watched anything with her in. But I watched it because everyone was talking about it. And it really is worth a watch. Like, her life is just insane. And it's so interesting. Like, I've not for one second been bored while I've been watching this. I think you've got your food over there, but I'll give you some crust. The tray's wet, by the way, because I just washed it and didn't dry it properly. But yeah, there's my lunch. This bread is so, so good, honestly. We've moved on to cookie and tea time, and I'm just watching Sophia and Cinzia. They're actually talking about the Flow app, the period app, which is the one that I use, fun fact. Rue is attention seeking. Oh, excuse me. Sometimes I think she just doesn't like it when I'm talking to the camera because she thinks there's no one else here, so I must be talking to her or something. I don't know. But anyway, I'm going to enjoy one of these cookies and my cup of tea. And then I think we need to probably, you know, do something a bit more productive with the afternoon.
I don't know where this afternoon went. Actually, that's a lie. I do know where this afternoon went. I did way too much scrolling on my phone. Did too much watching TV. I think I'm just going to find like a 20 minute, probably like lower body glutes kind of workout of some description. Just something to get me moving a bit. I'm literally just going to do my workout in this. I've got leggings on and then I've got a hoodie on. Listen to how she growls at me when we play. Listen to this. If I touch her tummy. Oh, you're not going to do it now, hmm? Listen to that.
So this is the workout I've chosen. It's by Move with Nicole. I've not done one of her workouts before, but she's someone I always hear people talking about. So we're going to go for it. It's called 20-minute thighs and booty Pilates workout. Rue currently thinks it's playtime, so I don't know how this is going to go, but let's find out.
Let's start our class today standing at the back of our mat with our feet. Nice inhale at the bottom of the face and the outside of our left glute. Last one. 7, a little higher. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. And last one. 8. Try to keep everything else still. You're really working your inner thighs here. 3, 2.
Did you see how difficult that was with this one? Excuse me, what have you got to say for yourself? Did that need to be that hard for mum? Need to be? So we're going to tidy this room. Tidy this room. Yeah, we're going to tidy up and then... and then... we can make some dinner or have a bath or whatever we do next, can't we? How good does this look? Let me take you by the light, actually. I just cooked this all by myself. Kenny did send me instructions, but I just made it. Although, I would have shown you the full recipe, but I feel like Kenny will be better at that, so we'll do that when he's home. But I will just quickly show you the sauces I used to make this little stir fry on a bed of quinoa and brown rice. Let me just show you. So, these are the sauces. Excuse the mess. I've been cooking. It's a bit chaotic in here. But this is one sauce. I also use soy sauce. And then finally, this teriyaki sauce. But that's the main combo. But I'll show you properly when Kenny can make this with us. Hello. Am I already showing you this? I don't know. But one of my birthday presents this year, Kenny got me a few like rituals bits. They're magnesium bath crystals. They are sacred wood and lavender. And they're just so good. They're honestly so relaxing. Just put them in my bath. The whole bathroom smells amazing. I absolutely love them. But anyway, so that's what I'm going to do now. I feel like for someone who literally just today said they were thinking of doing like weekly vlogs and then another video, this has not been the most fun-packed, riveting weekly vlog this week. But do you know what? In some ways, I kind of like that, because if I'm going to potentially at some point commit to doing weekly vlogs, and some weeks are going to be like this. You guys know me. I'm such a home bird. Is that the word? Home bird? Home bird? Homebody, homebody. So I'm gonna actually go now. But thank you guys so, so much for being here. Thank you so much for watching. And also just an extra bit of love for you guys that watch my weekly vlogs and for everyone that commented or DM'd me or messaged me off the back of last week's video talking about insecurities. I'm really trying, as you guys can see, we're trying to stick with it. I look exhausted tonight as well. So it really does mean the entire world to me. Just sending you so, so much love, and I hope you have the best week ever. Bye guys.